Welcome to Halas Hall Pass here at Halas Hall. I'm Dan Weeder, joined by Rich Campbell. Busy week one here at Halas Hall as the Bears prepare for Sunday's game in Houston against the Texans. And Rich, the biggest news today was the official announcement of the four-year contract extension for Kyle Long, a move that's obviously well-deserved for a guy who's gone to three Pro Bowls after his first three seasons, but also a contract and a new deal that comes with several layers to it. Your initial reaction to the deal for Kyle?
Well, I think, first of all, long-term, it's really a no-brainer. I mean, if you're Ryan Pace, you're John Fox, you want to build around players like Kyle. Good at football, first of all, but also have the intangibles, right? The toughness, right. The charisma, the energy, the ability to bring players together. Kyle's got all that. So that's what you want out of your cornerstones. But when you say, okay, it's a no-brainer, then why, out of all the possible times that they could execute this deal, why now?
Right.
And then, so that's what we have to ask ourselves. And we asked Kyle that today. He said, you know, the longer you wait for on these things, the uglier they get.
Yeah.
He's still under contract, though, for two more years. So really, this is an early extension. And so naturally for me, I think about the left shoulder. And you wonder what type of concerns that the Bears and Kyle Long have about his shoulder behind the scenes. Obviously not long-term concerns because they're willing to commit to him. But for this season, if he believes that it's going to affect his play, it's obviously going to affect his tape. Maybe affect his negotiating position. I mean, we're kind of getting down the road
right
here, but you understand that a lot goes into this.
I was going to say that those are questions that we'll have answers to better 2 months from now when we have 2 months' worth of games to see how he's performing, to see if he's actually showing progress and not regressing with some of the limitations that the shoulder injury will cause. I think you hit the nail right on the head at the outset about the fit here for the Bears and Kyle Long. I think when you talk about a guy who's very conscientious about what he does, a guy who comes to work with enthusiasm, these are things that John Fox loves in his building blocks. And I think back to the first day we got to training camp and Kyle was reflecting on the growth he's made since he was a rookie and talked about being on the practice field and in meetings as a rookie and making a ton of mistakes on the field and being unable to correct them in the meeting room. And Jamarcus Webb telling him, look, man, you're the first round pick. The stakes for you are big. And if you don't get these things figured out and corrected, heads are going to roll around here. And Kyle talked about the impression that made and just how much it helped him sharpen his work habits. It helped him figure out what was at stake here and really has shown great progress in his career, deserves credit for all those things, obviously is going to get the financial rewards for that now. And the Bears will hope that they can get the best out of Kyle Long going forward.
Well, yeah, and I think the best is yet to come for Kyle. And he even talked today about how he's learning football, learning how to see football. Dave Magazu, the offensive line coach, earlier this year talked about Kyle's understanding of what's going on around him. Continues to get better, and so as you continue to package that, the end product improves. And I think it'll be really interesting to see Kyle moving back to right guard where he's most comfortable. But again, the left shoulder, how much is that going to limit him? How much is it going to test his strength, range of motion, pain tolerance, all that? For me, it's going to be a week-to-week thing. I think Kyle understands that as well, and I'm really interested to see how he holds up against J.J. Watt.
I was just going to say, Sunday in Houston, welcome to Energy Stadium. J.J. Watt will be waiting for Kyle Long there, and we'll get a pretty good matchup of two guys who have been to the Pro Bowl a time or two. Stick with us all throughout the week for plenty of coverage and plenty of preview looks at the Bears-Texans in Houston this weekend. That'll do it. For Rich Campbell, I'm Dan Weeder. We'll see you.